Hello everyone, welcome to this quick tutorial on Spring Boot filter. Today we'll understand what is filtering Spring Boot, what are some common use cases for filtering, and how we can achieve filtering in our Spring Boot application. So let's dive in. Filtering is a component in Spring Boot which intercepts and processes all the incoming requests and also the outgoing responses. So a filter in Spring Boot application sits between a client and a resource or a controller. So when a request is made by a client, with filtering we can achieve logging of the request, we can check authorization and permit or reject the request, we can modify the request headers, we can modify the request body, and many more. So filter provides us the benefits, and now let's see how we can achieve this kind of filtering in our Spring Boot application. So here we have a REST controller which serving a list of string actually. Now we want to have filtering in our Spring Boot application. Here we have a package called config. Inside that config package I'll be creating my filtering. So let's say I want to log all the request and response with a filter. So I'm creating a filter called logging filter. So this logging filter have to implement the filter interface which comes from servlet. This is the filter we want to implement. This comes from jakarta.servlet. So we have to implement the method in that interface, and there are three methods. One is init and destroy and do filter. Init and destroy, as the name says, for initialization and destroying. And another method is do filter, which is mandatory to implement. In this method we have three parameter. One is servlet request, another one is servlet response, and the last one is filter chain. So we have to call the filter chains do filter method once again, because this will pass the request to the resource or controller or to another filter. Okay, so this is mandatory to call. We'll call filter chain dot do filter, and the parameter is servlet request and servlet response. So this is one way we can implement our filtering, but in order for Spring to have this filter in its container, we need to annotate this filter with add component annotation. Okay, now every time a request comes, the code we put before this filter chain to do filter method will be executed before the request is processed from the controller, and everything we put after the do filter method will be executed after the request is processed and response is generated from the controller. This is one way to implement the filter. If a controller or resource dispatch the request internally to another controller, then this filter can be executed one more time. So if we want to make sure that a filter get called only once in a HTTP request, we can extend the OncePerRequestFilter class instead. In that case, we have to implement another method called doFilterInternal, which is pretty much same. It has three parameters. One is request, one is response, and another one is filter chain. And anything we write before this doFilter method will be executed before the request is processed from the controller, and anything we write after this do filter will be executed after the response is generated. Okay, so this is one way. Now another way is to use filter registration bin. Let's say we want to have our filter with filter registration bin. In that case we have to implement our filter, but we do not want to make this a component, but instead we want to create another class as Spring configuration. Let's name the class filter bin config, and inside that class we have to implement a method which returns a filter registration bin of the type of filter, and we have to make the class a spring configuration like this, and implement a method which returns filter registration bin of the type of our required filter. So here we want to have login filter, and we are returning a filter registration bin of type login filter, and inside that method which is returning a bin, we can set some additional parameter like URL patterns and the order. The URL pattern means that any URL that matches this pattern will go through this request filter before the request is passed to the controller or resource. And we can also set the order here with a setter method, and if a request matches with this pattern, then the code before this method will be executed before the request is passed to the controller, and the code after this method will be executed after the response is generated. These are the ways we can implement filtering in our Spring Boot application. I hope you got the idea. I'll see you in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching.